Hey, good day there. This is Joe Van Cleve. Welcome to another episode of the Typewriter video series. Today, I'm going to be discussing how to adjust your typewriter's upper and lower case positions, and also how to check for what we call shading, or when the letters are faint on the top or bottom. Well, you might be aware of when your typewriter's alignment isn't correct is when you go to type your capital letters and the capital letters don't line up to the same line level that your lowercase letters do. It's not that difficult to adjust. You have to know what kind of machine you're dealing with and where the adjustment points are and how to do it. So let's delve into this, shall we? Well, one of the first things you have to know about your typewriter is what kind of shifting mechanism does it have. What I have here are an example of two portable typewriters. On your left is an old 1920s era Corona 4, and on your right is a probably 1950s era Olivetti Lettera 22. The Corona 4 is called a carriage shift because when you shift to the uppercase letters, the entire carriage mechanism moves up and down. The Olivetti Lettera 22 is called segment shift, and you can see a little more clearly that the shifting with a segment shift, it shifts the segment down. So adjusting both of these machines is going to be done in a little bit different order depending on what the problem is and what kind of machine it is. So let's take a look at that. Now, before you go into the machine and just start adjusting things, you have to kind of do a test on your machine to see what more precisely the problem is. And the reason why is because there's a certain order that you want to do this adjustment in. I always recommend that the first thing you want to do is you want to adjust the lowercase position. Now, it might surprise you to learn that there are hard stop adjustments not only for the uppercase, for the shifted position, but there is actually adjustments for the lowercase. And that adjustment is to make sure that the letters are all printed evenly, so the tops and bottoms of the letters are all nice and dark. And I've made a little chart here to show you this, but basically what it means, this is sort of looking at a typewriter from the right side of the platen. This is a cross section of the platen roller where your paper goes through. And this is kind of a representation of one of the type bars and the type slugs hitting the platen where the paper will be and the ribbon will be. And a properly aligned typewriter, you're going to have the center of the letters is going to hit at the tangent point right on to the platen so that the letter makes an even imprint along both the top and the bottom. Now, I didn't really draw in this simple diagram the fact that these type slugs are actually slightly curved to match the curvature of the platen. But a properly aligned typewriter, you're going to have even shading is what it's called on the top and bottom of the letter. And you want to adjust that shading adjustment for the lowercase letters first. So this is an example when the shading is properly adjusted. The alignment between the type slugs and the platen is proper. You don't have any shading on the top or bottom of the letters. Now here's an example of what you might call top shading. This is where the type bars, the type slugs are hitting too high on the platen relative to the platen. You'll have shading on the top of the letters. That is, the top of the letters are not going to be as darkly formed as the bottom of the letters. Okay. This could be the type bars are too high or the carriage is too low, depending on whether it's a carriage shift or a segment shift machine. Next, we have an example of bottom shading, and it's just the opposite of top shading. Here, the type slugs are hitting the platen too low, and the bottom of the letters aren't making a firm imprint. So, which condition you have, top shading or bottom shading, you're going to want to first determine that on the lowercase letters and adjust those letters first before you go to adjust the uppercase to match the lowercase. Now let's look at a couple typical typewriters and see where those adjustments are and how you do it. So this is the underside of the Olivetti Lettera 22. I've taken off the four bottom feet that have screws on the center, which removes the bottom panel. And this is basically looking at the center of the typewriter underneath. Here's the segment where all the type bars are. But you're going to see a adjustment. There's a little arm here with a little screw and a nut. And there is another little screw and a nut right here on this plate. So it's at the lowercase position right now. So this plate, the position of it relative to the plate behind it, determines the lowercase position. And what determines how close it can go to that or how far away is this screw, the length of it. There's a slot on the end of the screw that you can adjust it, and there's a locking nut that you use to lock it into place. So that the position of this screw, how far it extends behind this arm here, determines the lowercase setting. The shifted setting, or the uppercase setting, here's shifted. You can see in the shifted position, it's determined by the position of this other screw on this other bracket. And again, it has a slot in end to adjust it, and there's a locking nut to lock it into place. Okay, on the Corona 4, which is a carriage shift machine, I've flipped the machine back up on its back end, so you're looking at the underneath side of it. This is the right rear foot of the machine. There is a set of adjustment screws for upper and lower case on both sides of the carriage. So this is on the right side of the carriage underneath. So for the lowercase position, it's going to be the height of this screw right here. And let me push the carriage back down. That's the lowercase position. So in the lowercase position, the height, the length of this screw determines that. And there's a lock nut, of course, behind it also. You can see the spring right here that actually helps to pull the carriage down. And then the shifted position is going to be set by this screw right here. And it also has a locking nut. Now there's the same set of adjustments on the left side of the machine, and you want to adjust both sides at the same time, at the same amount. Now the basic principle of these screws and nuts is you can sort of illustrate with this larger sized bolt and nut. But basically you're adjusting the actual screw, and then you're locking down the nut. So the screw and the nut are jammed together and nothing can turn. So the nut is a jam nut that keeps the screw from moving. And to adjust these adjustments, you have to first loosen the nut. Then you can turn the screw however it needs to be. And once you get it to that point, you re-tighten the nut down so it can't move anymore. I should mention that before you go into adjusting your typewriter, you really should do a thorough cleaning and lubrication first. But after having done that, you're going to find, based on the brand of the typewriter, that those little screws and especially the nuts are either going to be metric or they're going to be American standard. And so it's a good idea to have a set of wrenches for both. Now keep in mind that a lot of the machines, getting to these little locking nuts can be a challenge. And back in the days of typewriter repair, there were specialty tools explicitly made for typewriter adjustments. So unless you're lucky to have an old typewriter repairman's toolkit, you're going to have to kind of make do with gunsmithing tools or other kinds of tools you might find. I just happen to have a couple little open-end wrench sets that I use. I have a metric one here, and these oftentimes are pretty handy for getting into those little lock nuts. You have to loosen the lock nut, then you have to use a thin flat-bladed screwdriver to turn the little screw, and then you tighten the lock nut down without turning the screw, right? And then you have to test it, and then you go back and have to readjust it, loosen the lock nut, adjust it some more, tighten the lock nut, test it again. It's an iterative process you have to do over and over and over again until you get that adjustment just right. And as I mentioned earlier, for the machines that have adjustments on both sides of the carriage, For your lowercase position, you want to adjust both of them so they're at the same position, so they're both touching where they need to be, and the lowercase has no shading. Then you can adjust the uppercase to the lowercase. Let's look a little bit more detail about that. So again, for the Olivetti Letter of 22, now that you have your lowercase set, your uppercase adjustment is going to be adjusting the position with this screw. And again, you're going to loosen that lock nut first. You're going to turn the screw and then hold it with your screwdriver while you tighten the locking nut. Okay, so it's tight, and then you're going to check the alignment. And to check the alignment, you're going to want to type both upper and lowercase letters and make sure that they line up together. Now again, for the typewriters that have adjustments on both the left and right side, you're going to want to do the uppercase adjustment to both sides evenly. This is the Corona 4. Here's the left side adjustments. This is the this was the lowercase, as we mentioned earlier, and your uppercase adjustment is right here, okay, right there. So again, you're going to adjust both left and right uppercase adjustments so the uppercase matches the lowercase. Now, sometimes you can have other problems that look like your upper and lowercase needs to be adjusted, but it's not really the case. Here's a great example. I took my Corona 4 out this morning to prepare it for this video, and as soon as the first sentence that I typed, look at that, the uppercase J was much higher than the lowercase words. The uppercase C of Corona is much higher. I don't know if you can see that very easy, but misaligned immediately. And I thought, oh my goodness, it wasn't doing that the last time I used it. Well, what I did then is I took off the right ribbon spool. These Corona 4s have a problem where modern ribbon spools are very tight inside the ribbon cover. And as soon as I took this ribbon cover off and started typing some more, all of a sudden, look at this, the upper and the lowercase letters lined up. And as soon as I advanced the ribbon a little bit to some more darker, fresher ribbon, I got a nice dark imprint, and both upper and lowercase were aligned, and I never had to do any adjustments. The problem turned out to be the ribbon was being hung up in the reel. And if you look at the way this thing shifts, when it shifts, you notice it's pulling on the ribbon. Okay, the ribbon is being pulled a little bit. And if that ribbon can't adequately move, it's going to cause the shifting to hang up. It'll prevent the shifting from happening. So if you have one of these older machines with the ribbon spool covers, cause the ribbon to be really tight, you want to maybe take the covers off, and you'll find that it frees up the shifting action. Now, the shift lock is simply a little latching mechanism on the shift lever. You push it down and it locks into place and keeps the shift lever from coming back. The problem on some of these machines is the shift lock position has play. There's play between the shift and the shift lock, and if that's the case, at the shift lock position, it won't be in the same place as shift. And so what you have to do is you have to adjust the little linkage in here so when the shift lock trips like that, there's no additional play on it, okay? So I can push on the shift lever and the shift lock, there won't be any up and down movement. So in summary, first of all, make sure that your machine is cleaned and lubricated first before you go into adjusting these things. Second, make sure that the ribbon is free to move. And if it's a segment shift, make sure the ribbon is not hanging up as it's shifting to keep it from going up all the way. Then you have to know whether you have a segment shift or a carriage shift machine. And again, the first thing is to adjust the lowercase position so your shading is even, right? Secondly, then you go adjust your uppercase to match the lowercase. I like to use upper and lowercase L's. That's always a good way to check the alignment of the letters. But don't just rely on one letter, because you might have a typewriter where that one particular L slug might be mispositioned. So after you think you got it good with a set of letters, go test it out by typing upper and lowercase of all the letters and make sure everything is consistently good as it can be. Make sure that those locking nuts are locked down tight enough so that those set screws don't turn, and use the right tools, use the right wrenches, because you don't want to strip out the corners of your locking nuts. And after you've done this, you'll be much more satisfied with your typewriter if the upper and lower case can match and make a good quality imprint. Well, this is Joe Van Cleve. Have fun typing. Have a good day.